G'day, it's Clayton from Planet Canada here, and today I'm stoked to chat with you about a really cool feature found in Cabinet Vision. Often when we're drawing up projects or jobs for our customers or clients, they might ask that we incorporate a design, a color scheme with multiple different materials. Often it will depend on the exposed materials as opposed to the interior materials. In Cabinet Vision, that is a really easy feature to control. If I was to, for example, open up my job properties just now and go to the material schedule that I'm using, you would see that I have the ability to manually change the material associated with my exposed or interior pieces in these cabinets. And that would just be as simple as me searching for the material I would like to have assigned to what part. But today we're going to focus on something specific, the banding, and how we can toggle between the different options of our banding, but also change the default settings and add more categories if we would like. So you can see at the moment, my system has access to two different kinds, exterior banding and interior banding. If say, let's say for example, I wanted to modify just a single part in my cabinet, just so that it has a different banding option compared to the rest of the cabinet, the rest of the parts, maybe even the rest of the job. I could click twice on my cabinet properties. I could click on the, let's say the finished left end. And if I clicked on the edge banding options after I right clicked on the part, you could see that now I could change this manually to be the other option, the interior banding perhaps, or I could keep it the exterior banding. I could change the other edges to incorporate the exterior banding or the interior banding too. So this gives me the option to manually change this part. And I could do this with any of the parts I find in Cabinet Vision, but I don't really want to do that for every single part or every single cabinet in my job. That would just take too long. Well, I can also modify the standards, the defaults for each and every single one of my parts, every single time a cabinet is attached to a wall. And that is also a really easy feature. Let's say, for example, I went to my job properties and I looked at my construction method properties that I'm using. If I modified for this job, I could open up, let's say the exterior case and the finished end. And if I double click on these options, you'll see I can choose which edge banding material is the default, or which category is the default, rather. So at the moment, the face of my finished end is going to use the exterior banding. I could just as easily change that to be interior banding. And now every single time I bring in this cabinet, into the job, I will see the interior banding attached automatically to the face. Well, that's fantastic. I can toggle between interior and exterior banding very easily. And I can also make these modifications in my job and just this job so that each project can have the special requirements met. But maybe you would like to have more than these two options. Maybe you would like to have three, four, five, etc. You could also organize them according to maybe a different system than interior as opposed to exterior. Well, that is a really easy feature to do too. What we will do is close the program. And then we will click on the part icon, the part material manager. And then we will click on the part manager. And here we have a list of every single piece which exists in our cabinets, in our projects, everywhere. So for example, if I clicked on the case, you would see I've got the finished left end, the unfinished left end, the finished right end. All of these are categories in my material schedule that I could associate with a specific material. You'll also see the name here. This is just a specific code that the program uses that we could even reference later on in, say, UCS or in the more advanced aspects of the program. But often you will probably just be concerned with the description, as that's the name you will easily recognize as a designer or engineer using the program. If I was to click now on the banding option of my assembly, you'll see that I've got my exterior banding and my interior banding. I could rename them if I wanted them to be separate, but if I wanted to keep them and add in other options too, it's a super simple process of clicking on the new, where I must attach a name to one of these new options. So let's just say we did the G option there. You'll see that there is from A to Z. So we've got 26 options available to us, 26 different edge banding options we could incorporate. Here, maybe I want to add a white banding 2mm option available to me. So now that I've got that set up, the white banding 2mm, if I just hit return and went to my material schedules, you'll see that every single one of my assembly material schedules now has this white banding 2mm option ready. If I wanted to, I could associate a white banding material, and here's one I prepared earlier. I could associate that here to the white banding 2mm option. So now, every time I use this schedule in a project, if the white banding 2mm option is associated with an end, it will be using this white banding 2mm. And of course, the categories could go on. I could continue with various thicknesses. I could just continue with different finishes. Maybe I'm more interested in having a white banding, black banding, a color banding, mismatch color banding option available to me. But that's up to you, and you can customize it however you like. But once this is set up, it's as simple as me now going into a job and making sure that option is ticked where necessary. Maybe if I wanted all of my parts when I use the construction method to automatically reference that category, I could just go into my assembly or construction properties. I could find the piece that I might like to associate it to. So let's go to the finished end. And now, instead of for the back none being the default, I could associate the white banding 2mm. And now every single time I bring in a cabinet which uses a finished end in my project, it will use this white banding 2mm color. I could add it like so, and yes. And then when I visit the properties for my job, so if I opened up a new job like so, and then from the job properties, I could toggle to the, that's the construction method we're using, the material. Now I could modify just for this project that it uses, maybe a different material as opposed to the white banding 2mm. But if I clicked on OK, now I can go to my objects. I can bring in a new part. And now if I wanted to, I could do the exact same thing we did at the start of the video and modify my edge banding. But here I could switch him to be white banding 2mm. And there you go. It's as easy as that for us to switch between the different edge banding options or even create new categories in Cabinet Vision. Once this is set up, drawing those very custom, very detailed jobs becomes so much quicker and more efficient. Thank you. Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision Power user.